Good morning and good evening. Welcome to the chanting session, where the aspiration is that we chant till we become the chant. So invoking Divine's grace and presence as we spend the next few minutes chanting. So we'll start with Om today. We'll do it for some time. Just a reminder to be as conscious, as present as possible for us while we chant, so that we can start developing that awareness more and more in everything we do.
Thank you.
hoping that we are more gathered, more settled after chanting Om. Our thoughts, our chores, they don't seem to leave us. So sometimes it's good when we sit, just give them some moments and say that right now, you're not allowed. Right now, no matter what can happen, will happen during the day, anything urgent, anything important, it can wait. The next few minutes is just for myself, without chores, without responsibilities, without duties. So with this small interaction with my thoughts, I will share the next chant, which is Astoma. We haven't done it in some time, so we'll do it again.
Shanti.
So I'm assuming you can hear the sound. If not, you'll unmute to Astoma Sadgame for the next few minutes.
Mrityorma
That was one of the most beautiful prayers that we can, I would say, pray. The most beautiful aspiration, the most beautiful demand, the most beautiful request we can make to the universe, to the divine. Take me from falsehood to the truth. The more honest I am, the more aware I am, I see I'm surrounded by faults in and around me. I just talking about myself, maybe I would say more than 95% of what I do, what I think, it's attached to falsehood. It's operated from the wrong center, most of it. Things that matter not. You know, it is said in the Upanishads that when we wake up from a dream, especially a bad one, when we wake up, we're like, oh, thank God, it was a dream. No, it wasn't real. And so we wake up from this birth that, oh, it was just a lie. It wasn't real. And yet, I am so strongly identified with this name, this body, this title, its roles and responsibilities, that who I am is forgotten. So I'm praying in this prayer that take me from the false to the truth. Take me from darkness to light. Both live in me. And I'm aspiring for more and more light because without grace, I cannot get it. I cannot see it. I walk as if I'm blind. The glitter catches my attention. The gold is rusted, although the gold never rusts. And I'm praying to be connected to that immortality that I am, that consciousness that I am, which is Ajanma, which is never born, which never dies. But my life, in which I'm always protecting myself, safeguarding myself, caring for myself, that is more in connection with saving lives, which cannot be associated with immortality. I know it, and yet it's far, it seems far. So aspiring and praying to be connected to that higher essence, higher consciousness that I do have access to all the time. So we'll end the session with Om Namo Bhagavate. That would be the last chant for today. If you can't hear me, please do. Om, which Mother says is a signature of God. Namo, the deepest surrender. Bhagwate, may the divine manifest in me. So Om Namo Bhagwate, a chant which has the power to transform the physical cells of the body according to the mother. So I'm chanting something all the time, 24/7, my mind is running. So if I have to chant, I aspire to chant that which can take me above the chatter. I aspire to chant the highest possibility for me. So may I chant till we become the chant. With this aspiration, with this prayer, we can end the session. Thanking grace, thanking divine for the ability, for the inclination, for the blessings to be able to chant, to be able to comprehend, to be able to sit, to be able to understand, to be able to want to be better, purer, wiser, smaller at the same time. Thank you.